Hi everybody, this is a project I've been looking forward to for a long time, an outdoor kitchen. It's nice cooking over a wood stove in the wintertime, but in the summer, cooking outside is the way to go. So here's my version of an outdoor kitchen. Hope you enjoy. I picked this spot because it's nice and shady in the summer. Getting started, pretty much you have to remove all the topsoil, all those forest roots, get down to sand, something hard to pour some concrete on for a good base.
Charlie, get out of the hole.
One and a quarter. Oh, way up, 62.
Got it laid out about where I think it's gonna sit, so I'm just gonna trace around it and inside it. You can see my...
If you're a block layer, this next part of the video might be hard to watch. I have no idea how to lay block the right way. I didn't do any research to figure out how to lay block the right way, except for how to get the mud to stick to your trowel. And if you're not a block layer, there's your heads up. Don't follow my lead.
I
pretty good.
Yes. Two grades. Wasn't expecting that. Looks like I got it set up about right though. Although I'll have to cut one run. So I mocked up the grill. Got it figured out about how I wanted to do it. Now I just need to take it apart and make it permanent. Right there. That's what I learned from the 2 minutes of block laying video I watched. Clearly not enough.
Actually pretty level. The ones in the middle are kind of low.
I wish I would have thought this through a little better. If I would have put another block, just a chunk, below that pipe, it would have raised the pipe up a little higher and it probably would have drew the smoke out a little better. It still works, but it probably could have worked better.
It should work. That's level. That's pretty level. Sure it's gonna fit this all the way back.
So this needs to get cut down. It'll end right here. And then for the other side, I got this stainless steel griddle. I cut this slab of pine on a sawmill I used to have probably 5 years ago. Sat outside for two, and then I decided I wanted to keep it. Put it in my woodshed, and it's finally getting used. See, tin slips will do the trick. No, they will not. Oh yeah, it's gonna break something. So I've got these pieces of angle iron. I'm gonna drill some holes in them and use them for mounting brackets for mounting my table. I'll cut one more of these and then I'll drill some holes. So I got my grate that I cut down. It fits about perfect. Pack it down nice. Yeah, I think that's a lot better. Finally, it's time to fire this thing up. A little birch bark will start a fire nicely. And Charlie knows what to do next. So I think this is kind of high. I think I'll end up using too much charcoal. So I'm going to bend this old grate where it'll fit.
think I waited too long to get the burgers over the charcoal. They're cooking kind of slow. I'm gonna see if I can add a little heat to it. Just stuff that under there. See how that does. I've noticed works pretty nice. I can put the bacon off to the side over top of these blocks, and it kind of keeps it warm, but it doesn't burn it any further. And do the same with this. Get it off to the side, keep it warm. And they're starting to cook pretty good. A little too good. Perfect. Well, the burger is delicious. The grill cooks great. It was a lot of work doing it, not knowing how to do block, but I didn't know how to do block, and it works great. It does a good job. So anybody can do it. It's a lot of fun. And in the long run, I think I'm gonna enjoy this for a long time. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. I know I will.